What's going on, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Fired Up Live. I am your host, Claudia Hoyser, and tonight, of course, is brought to you by FIREDISC Cookers. We have quite the show lined up for you tonight. They seem like they just keep getting a little bit more interesting around here. We've had some awesome talent, some amazing stories, and some really, really great music. So I can't wait for that to continue tonight with our special guest. And I just want to remind you that, like always, FIREDISC is going to be doing some great giveaways tonight. They'll be looking through the comment section below. So don't be afraid to get a little crafty with your comments, because we're going to be looking, seeing who's going to win that FIREDISC cooker. Also some swag packs and even some Hoyser Country Blend coffee, which I have next to me, but I don't want to spill my own because we are live tonight, and that would just be atrocious. So without me talking too much before we get started, I don't want to give away our guest just yet. Maybe you've been tuning in all week. You've seen who we were talking about, but this might be the first time you're hearing about it. I can't wait. I'm just going to sing you a little song first before we get to talking with her. So whether you're in your backyard with your family and friends, don't be afraid. Sing along from home. Why not? Let's do it together. This one's called My Church. I've cussed on a Sunday, I've cheated and I've lied, and I've fallen down from grace a few too many times. But I find holy redemption when I put this car in drive, roll the windows down and turn up the dial. And can I get a hallelujah? Can I get an amen? Feels like the Holy Ghost is running through ya. When I play the Highway FM, I find my survival singing every single verse. Yeah, I guess that's my church. When Hank brings a sermon, Cash leads a choir, it gets my cold heart burning hotter than the ring of fire. When this wonderful world gets heavy and I need to find my escape, I just keep the wheels rolling, radio scrolling till my sins wash away. Now, can I get a hallelujah? Can I get an amen? Feels like the Holy Ghost is running through ya. When I play the Highway FM, I find my survival singing every single verse. Yeah, I guess that's my church, yeah. Can I get a hallelujah? Can I get an amen? Feels like the Holy Ghost is running through ya. When I play the Highway FM, I find my survival singing every single verse. Yeah, I guess that's my church. Yeah, I guess that's my church. Yeah, I guess that's my church. It's my version of a little Maren Morris for ya. And I did that song a couple weeks ago now for Hoyser Country Monday, and I asked everybody to send in their videos of you singing along. So I'm still waiting on more videos to come in so I can put this together. We've had a bunch so far, and it's going to be fun. And I was only going to do a little section, but I think if we could get even more, I might do even more of the song. So sending your videos, singing along to my church, and maybe you'll see a little something fun on my page coming up here pretty soon. I'm going to be talking to a member of the Grand Ole Opry tonight, and she's got new music out that I'm excited for you to hear if you haven't already. I'm sure she's going to be sharing one or two songs from the new record. So let's just go ahead and get her on here. We're going to be talking with the beautiful Pam Tillis. You know her, you love her. Let's say hi to Pam tonight.
Hi.
Hi, Pam. How are you doing? You're
good. I'm going to get my technical guy to turn you down just a tiny bit, but I'm doing great. Thank you so much.
I'm all excited. I'm all excited to talk to you. So I got my loud voice on tonight.
No, you're fine.
Well, it's so great to see you and reconnect with you. We've been chatting a little bit here and there, and I know that times are crazy right now, and we just wanted to check in and see how is Pam Tillis doing?
All things considered, I can't complain. I've gotten some downtime, that's for sure.
And it's got to be strange. You've been on the road for a long time, and I think that's just a lifestyle you grow into. And how does it feel to switch that up?
It's so weird. You know, I think a lot of us entertainers are kind of addicted to adrenaline, you know, and you're used to running on fumes, you know. You just... I mean, I've just been traveling over 1,000 miles a week for most of the last 30 years. And that sounds kind of crazy. I mean, I've taken small breaks, but never this long. Mm-hmm. But it's just something that we're all having to go through together. We'll get on the other side of it. I was talking to somebody yesterday saying, won't it be great and be on the other side of this and say, remember when we had to do that? And we lived through it. We made it.
I can't wait for those conversations.
I cannot wait.
And when we're laughing about it.
People are going to go nuts.
I know. It's going to be crazy. But I just keep thinking back to when I met you, and it was about a year ago now. And we just put on a show, you know. I got to hang out with you a little bit before and after. That's when we really met. For everybody tuning in, I got a chance to open up for Pam and Lori Morgan in Winston-Salem. And just thinking from then to now, how everything has changed, and we're all sitting here wondering when the next show is going to be and when we're going to be able to get back out there. And I'm feeling for you because you're more used to it than I am. So I don't know. You're probably waking up well rested and wondering where those fumes are that you're supposed to be running on.
Yeah, right. No, it is really great to be in my own bed a lot. I will say that. But,
yeah.
You know. But exactly. I do miss the interaction, and it's weird.
Yeah, nothing like a live audience, especially at that show when I opened up for you. It was just a crowd like I've never experienced before. Everybody was hanging on every word. You sounded so beautiful, and that room is one of the most memorable nights of my life. So thank you for having me on that show.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, so you have new music out.
I do. It's a funny time to put out a record, but people are doing it. It hasn't hurt Taylor Swift.
No, not one bit.
Sure. Not one bit. But yeah, I got a new album, and it was a long time coming. So, you know, why hold up? Why hesitate? You know, it took me almost 2 years to do this one. I wrote a lot of the songs, and that takes me a lot of time. You don't hear all the ones I don't put on the record, you know.
Exactly.
But I'm proud of it, and we're gonna just slow walk this one in terms of promotion. A lot of times when you release a record, you know, you want all this giant push, and it's just like a moment in time. But I think with this one, I'm probably just gonna promote it over the next couple of years, and hopefully, at least some of that will be time that we'll be out on the road and getting to play it live.
Exactly. And at least right now, everybody can soak it up. So if you're listening tonight, if you're tuning in for this Fired Up Live, make sure you go check out Pam's new record. It's just full of amazing stories. And it's like a depth that I'm hearing from you, Pam, that it's very fun. And there's some funky songs on there that I wouldn't have expected from you. And I just love it. I've been really drawn to a lot of them.
Thank you. I liked your version. You sang one of them, Looking for a Feeling. You did a good. You did your own thing with it. That was cool.
Thank you
so
much.
Yeah, there's some, you know, my roots are very diverse. People know that I grew up, most people know that I grew up in country music and surrounded by the greats, you know, people that of 60s and 70s country music were my influential years, my formative years. But I also love rock and roll, and I love soul music, and I loved jazz, and I love classical. I loved everything, and bluegrass. I never really discriminated against any kind of music. If it was positive and had a good message, or, you know, had some kind of intelligence to it.
Exactly. Great music is great music. I feel the same way.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah. And so I've seen some great feedback and some awesome press about the record. So I've been all over Instagram. You know, you've got that little video teaser out right now.
Yeah. Yeah.
It just looks like such a fun time.
Well, it's, you know, one thing about being kind of housebound is you can have a lot of creative time that is a good thing.
Yeah. I've been working on a record myself, and it's about,
I
don't even want to say how many years in the making, but I'm going through the same thing right now. Like, do you put it out? Do you wait till you can go perform the songs? And you went ahead and jumped in, and I love it.
I think you just jump in, and because you can be promoting it for, you know, for a long time. So just, people, like you said, it's almost like we're housebound. We can be creative. And then all the people that are housebound, and they can be good listeners, you know, so it might be good symbiotic relationship.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay. Well, before I have you introduce the first song you're going to play for us, I want to know one thing that you've been able to do while you've been sheltering in place and staying safe. What have you been doing at home that you weren't able to do while you were on the road?
Wow.
A lot?
Pet my dogs every morning. That's like my, that, well, that's my routine. We don't let the dogs sleep in the bed, but my routine in the morning is to, make the coffee and then we let the dogs get up in the bed and we just watch the morning news and drink coffee and pet the dogs. It's
beautiful.
A really great, it's a nice routine. I mean, the news is depressing, but the dogs make it better.
Oh, exactly. As long as you have a fluffy thing next to you, it's
right.
All okay.
I've got a little pit bull. She's petite. And I call her my little furry Valium.
I love it. I love it. All right. So cheers. Thanks for reminding me that my coffee was next to me. You've tried the Hoyser Country Blend before.
Oh yeah. It's very good. I'm out.
I'm glad. What? Oh my
gosh.
Yeah,
I'm out.
How can we have Pam Tillis out of our coffee? We'll get you hooked up.
Okay.
Go ahead and tell us what you're going to play for us today, because we're so excited. We're on the edge of our seats.
Thank you.
We can't wait
to
hear a little acoustic from Pam.
Well, I'm a little bit rusty, but I'm here today, showing up in good faith, you know. But I'm going to do a song. It's an album cut from the record, but it's funny. It's taken on a little bit different meaning in light of the pandemic. Mm-hmm. And, but I think a lot of people maybe can relate to it, because one thing that everybody's noticed is how crazy people are to want to go outside and be outside and be in nature. Mm-hmm. And, it seems like they really need that healing, you know, just something natural in light of everything that's weird. And, so this song is a lot about that time in nature and all the restorative things that maybe don't come with a prescription, or things that come, you know, things that are free, like playing with your dog and going for walks in the woods and that kind of thing, talking to a good friend. So
beautiful.
This song's called My Kind of Medicine.
Let's hear it.
All right. Thank you. I got this for you right now, My Kind of Medicine, obviously taken on a few different meanings since this whole pandemic thing started, but I think there's probably something in there you can relate to. Sometimes these bones, they get to aching. Oh, when I just get plain tired. When everybody wants some of me. And I'm all worn out and wired. Oh, but I don't need no doctor. Something scribble on a little white pad. Cause it don't come in a bottle. All the side effects aren't bad. I find it walking in the woods, floating on the lake, and no one has to tell me how many I should take. And it comes in all the colors of a sunset painted sky, and it makes me high. You should try my kind of medicine. Oh, it don't take long to notice. This world is full of God-shaped holes. And if you get me to preaching, brother, I'll get on a roll. Oh, cause there's people out there peddling all kinds of counterfeit hope. Don't get me wrong, now I'm not meddling. If you ask me how I cope, well, I watch the same old movies that always make me laugh, and I throw that stick 100 times, watch my dog bring it back, and I saddle up the horses, get lost for hours out on a Sunday ride. Works every time. My kind of medicine. And I find it with a friend I can count on to be there. And I find it in the quiet times, talking to the man upstairs. And it comes in all the colors of a sunset painted sky, and it makes me high. You should try my kind of medicine. My kind of medicine.
That was amazing. Beautiful. Thank you. I love it. I love that one so much. So why don't you go ahead and tell us about your next one? And I do want to remind everybody to leave a little comment below, because we're going to be sifting through, and FIREDISC is going to be choosing three of you. A couple of you are going to win some swag packs. Somebody's going to win a FIREDISC cooker grill today, and possibly even some Hoyser Country Blend coffee. So make sure you're leaving some great comments below. And Pam, let's hear. What are you going to do second for us?
Okay, this is the single, or has been the last few months. And it's the title track of the album, Looking for a Feeling.
I love this one.
Thank you. It's a song that I wrote with my friend Waylon Payne. And he's a fantastic singer-songwriter. He's got a new record out. Check him out, Waylon Payne. All right. P-A-Y-N-E. I got to plug him because he's my good buddy. And he wrote this song with me. But, you know, it's going to sound kind of funny coming from me, but there was a song I had in the back of, you know, when you're going to a writing appointment, Claudia, I'm sure you've done this, and you're trying to go, if you don't have an idea already, you're like, oh, my gosh, what are we going to write about? What are we going to say? You know, mm-hmm. you're just it's like panning for gold. You know, you're looking for that, that special idea that's going to launch you for the day. Right.
Absolutely.
And so I was, and I really didn't have anything. And then I was in the car and I had a couple of thoughts come to mind. Remember the old, and I told you this song has a lot of different influences, a lot of 70s influences. And a song that I love from the 70s was a Lou Reed song called Take a Walk on the Wild Side.
Beautiful.
Because it was a bunch of interesting characters. And I thought it'd be cool to write kind of a country sounding version of that.
I love that.
So this song is has got the, all these characters in it, and they're all looking for something. And they're all in sort of predicaments, you know, and they're trying to figure out, just like all of us are. We're all human beings just doing the best we can. And I think that a lot of people talk about how much meanness there is out on the internet and how cruel people can be with each other. And I just wanted to write a song about, you know, that was non-judgmental. And these people are all just trying to do the best they can. They're trying to figure it out. And I'm not judging. I'm just, you know, talking about how we're all looking for a feeling. We're all trying to figure it out.
Absolutely. All right, let's hear it. This one's my fave.
Sisters on a sidewalk listening to the devil's lies. Brothers on a mountaintop trying to get wise. Looking for a feeling. Looking for a feeling. There's a man in a cover hole dying to get rich. Woman in a motel room with a 7-year itch. Looking for a feeling. Looking for a feeling. Now who can point a finger? Who can say what's wrong? Oh, we all get high and low, turning over every stone, looking for a feeling. Now buddy bought a Corvette trying to be young again. Jimmy skipped bare with his thumb out into the wind. Looking for a feeling. Looking for a feeling. And there's a couple in love, but they're both thinking about leaving. Wondering if the pain, the feeling's worth the promise they're keeping. Looking for a feeling. Looking for a feeling. Mm-hmm. Now who can point a finger? Who can say what's wrong? Oh, we all get high and low, turning over every stone, looking for a feeling. You can dye your brown hair red, you can mess up someone's bed. You can borrow, you can steal, you can draw, you can deal. Ooh. Oh, 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 yeah. 17 when I joined my first band. 21 when I gave a heartache my hand. Ooh, looking for a feeling. That
was such a cool, unique version to hear you do that by yourself. That was
awesome. Oh, thank
you.
Thank you, Claudia. I have a great band, full band, and then I have a trio that I travel with a lot, and it's two other women. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And they're so great and I'm missing them bad, but I do the best I can. I get the job done.
Absolutely. You do. But oh my gosh, we miss having everybody with us too. And I know how you feel. I know how you feel. So, okay. Fantastic. Well, I think we have time for one more. If you would love to tell us about the next one.
Oh, well, I was just trying to think what would be fun to do today. And there's a million songs I could pick from, and I've got a lot of albums, but I thought maybe it'd be fun. I'll just kind of do a little walk down memory lane, maybe a little medley for you, and a little taste of what we'll be doing when we get back out on the road.
Ooh, can't wait. Okay. I'm ready.
I ain't even gonna ask you. I can read you like a book. Girl, if I ever saw one that's not, can't believe it did that look. You look like something that the cat drug in. So I won't kick you while you're down. Just let me tell you, friend of friend, about a block I've been around. Did you really think last night would last forever? Did you really think that guy hung the moon? Right now you hate yourself 'cause you knew better. But there's no use crying over spilled perfume. No use crying over. No use crying over. No use crying over spill perfume. Love, you're getting lazy. You're forgetting to give me sweet sugar words that I want to hear. You've been neglecting me. You know jealousy, it is bitter as a green spring berry. Oh, and just like fruit from a fickle vine, turns sweet in the nick of time. Love, you only come alive when you're losing me. It's a childish game. I got to shake you up just to wake you up to make you love me. I'll shake the sugar tree till I feel your love falling. Gotta tell me what you planted. If you take my love for granted, baby, I'll shake the sugar tree. Shake the sugar tree. Oh, yeah. Well, I said he had a lot of potential. He was only misunderstood. You know, he really didn't mean to treat me so bad. He wanted to be good. And I swore one day I would tame him, even though he loved to run hog wild. Just call me Cleopatra. Everybody calls, I'm the queen of denial. If you're coming with me, you need nerves of steel. I take corners on two wheels. It's a never-ending circus ride. Faint of heart need not apply. Mi vida loca, over and over. Destiny turns on a dime. I go where the wind blows. You can't tame a wild rose. Welcome to my crazy life. Welcome to my crazy life. Thank you. I loved hanging out with you today. Thank you for letting me warble. I was getting a little rusty.
This is,
thank you.
This
thank
is
you.
Not the audience that you're used to, I know, but I'll do what I can for you today. That was so, so wonderful.
Thank
you for sharing your beautiful talents with us. And I know that everybody was looking forward to hearing from you today. So thank you for catching up with me and for Fired
thank
Up Live
you.
Here. I just want to tell everybody to make sure they go over to Pam's Facebook page and give it a like if you haven't already. I'm sure most of you have. And make sure you listen to her new album. Where do you want people to come find you and listen?
And also Instagram.
Instagram. Oh, yeah. And Pam, we know you're big these days on TikTok.
Well, I have been I'm a little bit behind, but I'll tell you what I like to do. I haven't been on there for a couple weeks. But what I really have been enjoying is singing duets with people on TikTok. We do the split screen thing. And
we're going to need to do that.
It's pretty darn funny. And sometimes it's serious, but sometimes it's funny.
Oh,
and
that's
a fun thing. But
yeah, there's a ton of Pam lovers out there on TikTok.
I've been
seeing them now that I followed you. I get everybody singing your songs. It's great.
Oh, I love it. I love it. And I like to try to match my video to their video. And it can be great.
Beautiful.
But and Instagram, like I said, and all the streaming platforms, you know, all the standard stuff. And if you want to write me a little note, you can message me those places or info@pamtillis.com if you got a longer question or a letter or whatever, you know. So
awesome.
You can find me.
All right, make sure you go write Pam a letter. How fun is that? Okay, we'll see you soon, Pam. Thank you so much. Stay safe, be well, and I'll talk to you next time.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
Well, wasn't that fantastic? Oh my gosh. I can't believe we have Pam on here tonight. I just think she's incredible, and I've been following along with her for a long time, and I hope you guys will do the same. So really, go check out that new record. It's so, so great, and it seems like there's something for every mood that you might be in recently, so go check it out. We had a couple questions come in from the last episode that I want to get to tonight in case I didn't get to everybody on the feed. I try to answer back as much as I can, but we had a couple fun ones come in. And somebody out there was wondering how I got connected with FIREDISC in the first place. And this is a pretty funny story because I truly didn't know what FIREDISC was. And I was in Texas at the time. I was getting ready to open up for Easton Corbin at the North Texas Rodeo in Denton, Texas, outside of Dallas. And I was just all excited about the show. I was totally in show mode, getting ready, you know, on backstage with my band and everything. And my manager calls me. You guys have probably heard me talk about him. Tony gets me on the phone and he says, "Hey, I just talked to this grill company. It's awesome." And I'm like, "You're calling to talk about grills with me right now of all times? I don't know anything about grills. What am I going to do with a grill?" And he's like, no, it's going to be great. It's going to change the way we go on the road. It's going to be so much easier, so cool. You're going to love it. I'm like, sounds fantastic, but I got to go. I'll talk to you later. So after all the crazy Texas stuff goes on, I get home and there it is. The FIREDISC cooker is sitting outside the studio and waiting to be set up. And as soon as I saw it, I realized why Tony was so excited about it and why he thought that I was going to care so much about it. And it really is because it's something I could do so easily. You know, you set it up in two parts, throw on the gas, turn it on, and make anything you want. And I just thought it was the coolest thing, and I love it so, so much. So I'm still getting better with it and trying to cook as much as I can here. It's been something that's keeping me busy. I'm no chef, no pro chef. I won't even try to fake that for you because some of you in the FIREDISC Cookers group on Facebook, you make the coolest, most delicious looking meals I've ever seen. And I'm trying to keep up with you guys. So keep those coming. I love seeing the pictures. Feel free to tag me in some of your posts because I'm always looking for new food and dinner inspirations. Another question we had was, what is my favorite grilled food? And I know I did just mention dinner, but I actually love breakfast on the FIREDISC. It's just no matter what, it's great every time. You can make everything and it's pretty easy too. And anything with shrimp. Shrimp is great. Grilled shrimp goes perfect with, you know, anything. You could put shrimp with anything. It's my fave. A little seasoning on there, a little of that FIREDISC seasoning. So good. So those were some cool questions. Keep those coming because I love to answer you guys and hopefully keep that part of the Q&A thing we've got going on. And I'm going to do one final song to wrap up tonight's episode. So this one's going to be a Claudia Hoyser original. If you guys don't know too much of my music yet, I'm hoping you will soon. I've got a new record coming out and I can't wait to share it with you. However, this song was from the first EP that we ever let loose. And this is the title track about following your dreams. It's called Steam.
These tracks run on for miles. And I daydream about the other side. I'll walk this line forever. Hope I get there before I die. This rail worn on the edge. The deeper the cut, the bigger the seam. I could hitch a ride in a boxcar over the mountain to my dream. Steam, don't run frozen. Takes a fire to be free. Steam, don't run frozen. I feel the burning in me. These wheels roll for ages. Where the iron and smoke trails rise. Throw more coal in the furnace. Gotta get there before I die. Steam, don't run frozen. Takes a fire to be free. Steam, don't run frozen. And I feel the burning in me. Gotta get there before I get. Feel the burning.
And that is a wrap on today's Fired Up Live. Thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in. We're trying to make this a very special part of your month. So keep hanging with us and comment below because we're going to have some amazing giveaways. Somebody commenting tonight is going to win a FIREDISC cooker. Two of you are going to win swag packs from FIREDISC. And somebody is going home with their very own Hoyser Country Blend coffee. So if you don't happen to be the Hoyser Country Blend coffee winner, you guys can find this on Amazon and hoysercountry.com. And if you aren't a very lucky winner of the FIREDISC cooker, you can go over to FIREDISC's website, firediscookers.com, and you can use my code Claudia Hoyser with no space, all lowercase, at checkout for a very special little discount code. And I'm just excited for you guys to try it. Keep hanging in with us. I can't wait to see you again for the next episode of Fired Up Live.
In today's world, time with family is more valuable than ever. Meet FIREDISC, the original portable propane cooker. It sets up in seconds, fires up fast, and cooks anything you throw at it. Whether it's a quick meal at home or in the great outdoors, FIREDISC has you covered. Take your kitchen outside and enjoy everything that makes good food great. FIREDISC, cooking at home made easy.